He's just a loving God. Well, the entire Old Testament is pretty much a comedy of God's errors and anger. He creates two people, sticks them in a garden in the most absurd situation, says, don't eat from this tree. I realize that he was probably a first-time parent in this scenario, but I think even the dumbest parent would know what was going to happen there. And so he has to punish them and exile them. And then the whole world goes to hell shortly thereafter. And so he picks out the most righteous man in his family and decides to build a ridiculous boat, which isn't seaworthy and couldn't hold all the animals. And then he's going to flood and kill everything except for this family, at least if you go for a global flood, which we know scientifically just is absurd. And no other civilization seemed to notice this global flood. So it must have been a local flood, which doesn't actually solve the problem of sin. And then right after Noah, you've got a couple hundred years where they do this massive population growth and they're building a Tower of Babel, which I don't know why a God would be, even the slightest bit bothered. This was clearly the mindset of these ancient people, that God lived somewhere up in the sky, even though, modern theologians say, no, that's not it at all, because clearly we can, travel to the moon. I don't know if we waved to God on the way past. And that fails and falls apart. And so then God decides, instead of trying to save everybody, he's just going to pick out his one favorite tribe, who happened to be enslaved, and I'm pretty sure they should have realized that there was a problem with slavery, and goes through this incredible scenario of, we're going to give all these plagues, and every time Pharaoh wants to actually let them go, God comes down and specifically hardens his heart so that he can show off a bit more. I want you to let him go, but I'm not going to let you make that. He violated Pharaoh's free will. It's explicitly there. Pharaoh, he hardened Pharaoh's heart so that he couldn't do it. Gets all the plagues out of the way, then these 3 million Jews, for which is no evidence that they were ever enslaved in Israel or in Egypt, there's no commingling of, and by the way, if they held hand to hand, the number of Jews that were there, they could have stretched from Egypt to Canaan in the first place. They're led across, all these miracles and everything else, miracles that would wow anybody living today. They get to Mount Ararat. Moses is gone for 40 days, and those guys say, screw that God. We'll make another one. This guy can't do anything right. And yet he specifically chose this universe where he knew he was going to have to keep failing and keep killing and keep failing and keep killing until he picked out his little special group and sent them around to keep failing and keep killing. And then there's this empty period. And he decides, I'm going to take human form, come down, sacrifice myself to myself to act as a loophole for rules that I created that I can't circumvent. I mean, it is logically absurd.